Legendary beat. Legendary beat. Legendary beat.
I get girl for my yard, we get big, big back away, they make me feel amazing, girl. I guess one way they give me things I need. I guess one way they make me feel nice. She slow dance, I know if you leave, I'm girl. I guess one way one give me keys and leave.
All right, so yes, we're still here on the show, The Takeover, and I've still got more questions for you. All right, now, many believe the show Big Brother is controversial. Ooh, your phone's going off. And yeah, in all honesty, many have, in a sense, picked up on the notion that, you know, the show doesn't really transmit the right values to youth. And I'm sure you must have heard all the different things that people pretty much have or perceptions towards the show. So do you see yourself as an adequate or appropriate role model after being linked to such a controversial show?
Yes. You see, the thing is, a lot of people are hypocrites. Yes. Mm-hmm. Even if Big Brother Niger was not on air, it wouldn't change the fact that people still do terrible things in the world.
Of course.
It wouldn't change anything. Now, the good thing is, yeah, for the show, because of the Senate, there was no shower, no bathing scenes and all. But basically, these are people that are living their lives. You know, Big Brother has taught me a lot. It has helped me push myself. There's so many things, even physical activities that I would never have dreamt of trying.
Yeah, I remember you, you guys working out.
Oh my goodness. You know, but it did make me a stronger person. That show made me learn that what doesn't kill you only makes you stronger, like literally.
True.
So I wouldn't say, yes, people have their notion. Some people who don't even watch the show at
just
all.
Just have their own perception.
Just have their own perception. But that's the way the world is. You know, you cannot please everybody, because you even have some religious shows that will probably be on. There are still people that would still criticize it, whether or not. So you can't satisfy everybody. For me, it has had a very, very positive impact on my life. It has had a very positive impact in my career. And I'm really grateful for it. Grateful to the organizers. Grateful to the wonderful talents I met on that show. Those housemates were amazing.
Aww.
And, you know, they helped push me, you know, to become a stronger person. So, yes, I do not see it as a bad, in quote, platform or show. No,
all
I do not. Not just because I was a participant, but even before participating in the show, I didn't see it that way. And I'm really grateful to the organizers. Yes.
Nice. Now, you know, as I said earlier, you definitely were the center of attention.
Oh.
We were all glued to watching you on screen, especially when your romance with, you know, TTT began. And then the love triangle that kicked off between you, him, and then T-Boss, and then you, him, and then Bali. What was it about the house that made people really fall for each other, or at least pretend to? And how much of Bisola's true feelings did we actually see?
Okay, the thing is, personally, I'm a very playful person.
Okay.
I love to joke a lot. That was why when I got close to a triple, and he told me how he felt for what he felt for T-Boss, I didn't think it was anything. It was not a big deal to me. It's like my guy telling me, oh, I'm liking this chick. Go ahead. You know, I went on and told her all of that, you know. So it was, when you're confined in a space, you don't have, you're not able to talk to family. You're not able to go on social media. You can't even watch television. Basically, the people you're living with, you know, are the ones that, they're your entertainment.
That's true.
Everything, every emotion you feel is with these people. So yes, just for, and besides, it's a show. You know, we have to give you full content. If not, you will not be asking me the questions. You know, so yes, it was a show. I knew what I was going into.
Yeah.
And yes, I learned a lot from the show, and it was fun.
So
was
there were absolutely no feelings at all?
No, because I remember there was a time when SA was telling me something about, oh, having a dream, yada, yada, yada.
Oh yeah, that was her way of telling you that he was married.
And I'm like, my answer to her was like, okay, but I'm not looking to marry this guy, so why are you saying all this?
Yeah.
You know, because it was just for the show.
Okay.
So coming out of the show, it's like, oh, more, now we are back in the real world. Can we get back to our grind and our hustle and all of that? So yeah, it was basically just for the show. For the show, yes.
All right. Well, now you've pretty much answered my next question.
Oh, okay.
Because I was going to ask you, you know, when in the house, I felt like you were, in a sense, blinded. I don't know. That's why I feel like maybe because you were, like, you did actually have feelings for him, but now you're saying you didn't. Because when you came out, you said that, you know, you felt betrayed that he didn't
open up
and be honest with you.
Yes, because I found a friend in him. You know that moment when you feel your friend, someone you take really close to, you can gist to, you can talk to this person, you can play with this person, you learn a lot from this person as well. And you know, I found, I have a daughter. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a thing of joy. It's a thing of pride. Mm. I could have as well gone in as a single parent and say, you know what, nobody must know I have a child.
Yeah.
You know, but it's a thing of joy. So I'm wondering, why would you hide such a joyful fact? But hey, it's your game plan. It's your strategy. Whatever rocks your boat, that's fine by you. So yeah, that's the only pain I felt like, guy, you're supposed to be my guy now. Isn't it worrying? Mm. You know, so that was it, basically.
Okay, but you guys have made up now, apparently. Now you actually hugged him. I feel like all the blogs went crazy when they were like, oh, but you just gave them white on side. And then now, oh, yeah.
Yeah, but there's no bad blood. There's no bad blood. He's doing his thing. I'm doing my thing. So, yeah, everybody is just back onto the grind and the hustle.
All right. Yeah. So, if you did have the opportunity to go back and maybe just change anything that happened between you and TTT, what would it be?
Oh, probably, yeah. If I knew he was married, obviously, I wouldn't have played so much, you know. Like, yeah, I'm a very playful person. Only people who are really close to me would know that Obisola, she's such a tease, you know. So, yeah, that's the only thing I would change if I was to go back.
Okay.
So high, like Amber Rose without a foreplay. Four fives, we getting money, baby, no shame. Hold tight, you're taking selfies, though you're so vain. Don't lie, you know I love it, baby, no way.
Okay, so let's head on to Twitter and see what your fans are also asking you. This one comes from at @Aderunke_Osaho. She goes, how did Layla react when she came back? And where did you tell her she went to?
Okay, Layla knew I was going to be away for a period of time, and I was going for a show called Big Brother. Good thing it was my mom and my sister. They didn't let her watch the show. They only allowed her watch the arena games.
Okay.
Yeah, so that was fine. And when I came back, I heard that she cried a lot because I didn't win.
Oh.
I didn't win the money. But obviously, when I saw her, we hugged and I was just kissing her whole face. We started playing, jumping on the bed, and I could genuinely feel that she had missed all of that. She had missed all of that.
Nice. Okay, well, the next one isn't really a question. It's from @life_Peppy. Okay. She even says, I don't really have a question for her.
Okay.
I just wanted to know she's amazing and an inspiration.
Thank you.
How does
so
it
much.
Feel to, you know, have this effect on so many people?
Oh my God. That's how I feel. Like, I don't have any words to explain it, but I'm just grateful that, you know, they can draw inspiration from me.
Mm-hmm.
I never knew I would be an inspiration to anybody at all, and so I'm just really thankful that at least I can, you know, do something positive to somebody.
Okay, now this is my final one from Twitter. This comes from @MoniNuolaji.
Okay.
She goes, wrong person. @HomaRao.
Okay.
She or he goes, hello Bisola, what are the next plans? Are you going into music or acting, or both?
It's going to be both, and I have two movies coming out real soon. There's Picture Perfect, that's coming out on the 7th of July this year.
Congratulations.
Yes, and then there's MFC, that's Music, Friendship and Conflict. Those are two movies, big projects that are coming out this year.
Nice.
And yes, I do have a number of scripts already lined up that I'm looking forward to recording and filming.
Mm-hmm.
And then songs, yes, a few producers I've spoken to, a few friends of mine, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff is going to come out real soon. I don't want to let the cat out of the bag yet, but you definitely would hear lovely songs from me and from some amazing people.
Excited. You know, I'm in a recent interview with Ibuka. He did speak about how, you know, if you play your cards right, you will, you know, be taking home an AMVCA come next year.
Hopefully,
the plan.
Every actor would love to be recognized and would love to, you know, take home the AMVCA.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, you know how big it is
mm-hmm.
in Nigeria and in Africa
mm-hmm.
as a whole. So yes, I would be looking forward. I'll put in my best in every production, you know, that I happen to be on, and hopefully it would be nominated and it would win an AMVCA. So hopefully, God willing. Yes.
All right. So what about love? Any hopes of finding love again?
Oh, definitely. There would be. This is life. It's just that, you know, I wouldn't use a torchlight and say, I'm searching for love. No. I think it's best if it just happens.
Yeah.
You know, I stumble on it and then, you know, you kind of enjoy it more. So yes, definitely there will be love in future. Not rushing into anything right now. I just want to make that money.
That's what's up. All right. Well, my final question for you, Bisola, is, you know, when you go into Big Brother, most people have a sort of misapprehension about people. So has there been any misapprehension about yourself that you really just wish you could erase?
If I could erase anything, like I said earlier, it would be the whole TTT. If I could go with TTT issue, that would basically be it. But I'm a human being. I know there were times I had a bit of quarrels with some housemates in the house. But that's why it's a reality show.
Yeah, these are things that
it's what happens in real life. So yes, that I basically was being myself in the house. Yes.
And any words of advice for your daughter?
For my daughter, make sure mommy's money for school fees does not waste. It doesn't waste. Keep making me proud. You're already doing a good job. I love you, and I pray that you would always stay positive, because you need that positive energy in everything that you do, and positivity would always follow you. I love you, baby.
Mo ti sọ fún ẹkọ yìí máa tẹ̀lé tó bí aláti ká lọmọ yẹn egó kú jù fún gobi. Reverse ọwọ́ ago sí o 13 tí mo drop throw sókè collabo bi 19. Tọrọ bread ni mi jọlọjọlọ no be my team. Tó bá ra mu àsètò wọlé no be my team. Láìláì baby never dance. Criminal ni mi ò mi ò kí n ṣàwádà. Fìlà gogoro mo sáyé lórí agbádá. Original gangsta mi ò lè ronú gbìnwádà. O ti yẹ ẹsìn, mo ti já ẹsìn. You can't buy class, pẹ̀lẹ́ ò ṣẹgbẹ́ mẹ́sìn. Tó bá ń gbọ́ OG, no be ordinary person. Ẹ̀kọ́ lè san old school fees pẹ̀lú lesson. Àlàyé tó ṣe gogo, gogo. Action pọ̀ bí ó gogo, gogo.